Well, yes, I think it's no secret that I'm pretty passionate about all things having to do with women's rights and empowerment and with politics, especially given what's happening in our super fun current political landscape.
That's great.
And as we've watched women's rights sort of come under siege and this insane conversation about how maybe healthcare shouldn't cover birth control, I'm like, where do you all think you came from? Yeah. Just curious, all you men making the laws, how do you think you came into the world? I started really having more and more conversations about what family planning looks like in my groups of friends with women who are my age, who are older than me, who are younger than me, and listening to some of their concerns, which then immediately made me go on like a research binge, because I love nothing more than good data, and I like, give me a graph all day. And I found out about this study that Teva did, and they found out that 1 in 2 women surveyed had reservations about hormones in her birth control, what hormones meant for her body, and didn't know that there's a non-hormonal option. And I thought, okay, we're blowing it. Yeah. The fact that educated, empowered, successful women don't know what their options are, what does that mean for young women? What does that mean for girls in college, for girls in high school? Why aren't we having these conversations, and why have our bodies become so weaponized? Why are our bodies treated like taboos? Why is like birth control like a whispered thing? And why is it like paper bag, bottom shelf, back corner, like heaven forbid you say period in public? Also like 51% of the population are women. Yep. There's somebody bleeding somewhere every day. Let's get over it. And I just thought, okay, I'm not shy about talking about fighting for women, representing women, wanting women to have whatever access to anything they need. And this is beyond a sort of political conversation. This isn't if you're a Democrat or a Republican. This is simply if you are alive, you should have access to facts about your body and your care, and you should not be shamed about any of it. And I was like, I want to talk about this. I want to talk about this everywhere. Let's stop whispering. Let's start shouting. So we wanted to put together a resource to make this funny and like donuts. We wanted it to be easily digestible. And the point isn't to say any kind of birth control is better than the other. Some people really need hormonal birth control. They treat period pain or endometriosis with hormonal supplementation. Some people don't react well to hormones and need a non-hormonal option. And none of us needs to not be covered, because clearly it's up to us to cover ourselves. Again, current landscape. And I just thought, let's do something fun and make this easy, because this should be easy for us to talk about. If we're hiding these conversations, if we're shaming our bodies, if we're embarrassed to talk about it, then it's going to get legislated that way as well. So, you know, stand up, show up, speak up, defend your fellow women.
Yes, kudos.
That's it.
We need like a clap. I need like sirens going off right now.